Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about the Motion Director Editing Mode, which allows you to create crowd and NPC motions in no time at all. Altogether, Motion Director has 6 different modes that can be used to create character motions, both manually and automatically. This feature will save you tons of time when making your own motion content for your project. If you're not familiar with Motion Director yet, please make sure to check out our Getting Started tutorial for a little background. Okay, let's take a look at General Player Control and Control with Path Mode first. The character on the screen has been loaded with an M01_PhoneWalk IMD file, which is one of many IMDs that can be purchased from the content store. You can find all of the free embedded IMDs in the free resources motion pack. The default motion director mode is player control, which allows you to control your character via input devices. In this case, we're using a keyboard and mouse, and when we hit start, you'll see our character walk around with his soda and phone in hand. Let's switch to Control on Path mode now, which you can also access from the main toolbar. You'll see that once we do, our character's name will turn red in the list, as we haven't assigned it a target path yet. Let's go up to the Create menu and select Create Path. Simply left-click to add points along the path. Once you're done, click on Pick Path with your character selected and choose the first path node to have him start from the beginning of the path. You'll also want to ensure that the start position percentage is also at 0. Since we want an overhead view of the entire path, I'm going to switch the camera view to free using the presets from the timeline. Once that's all set, let's give it a preview. As you can see, I can navigate the path using the W and S keys to move back and forth. Because we're using a path, the A and D keys won't be functional. One thing you may notice is that if there is a sharp angle turn in the path, the character may drift a bit more from the path than normal. This can be fixed by adjusting the IMD file settings. The two main parameters you want to adjust here are turn rate and turn trigger angle. When these values are low, you'll see a stronger offset of the character position from the path. However, when you increase these values, the character will conform more tightly to the actual path. Be aware that if you set these values too high, that you may encounter jittering. Next, let's take a look at Auto On Path and Auto In Zone modes. If I enable Auto On Path, you'll see that it's similar to our previous mode and that you need to select the path once again. However, this time you'll see a lot more parameters in the Action Settings section. What I'm going to do here is tweak the idle move ratio value higher in order to keep the character moving. There are various other time range settings here that you can adjust below, but let's keep it simple for now. The other values are dependent on the speed and perform of your IMD file. Once we hit start, you'll see that now the character will continue to move back and forth along the path without stopping. If we want to adjust the points along the path, we can do so from the Modify panel. You can put multiple characters along the same path as well. As you can see here, I have 4 different characters on this looped path, and each has a different percentage value for the start position parameter. Each character has a different IMD loaded as well, so it creates a certain level of variety, even though they're all along the same path. Let's take a look at Auto In Zone mode now. For this mode, you need to reference a prop to assign our zone range. It's recommended to use a floor or plane prop for this, both of which you can access from the Create menu. I already have a floor in the scene, so I'll just make it visible from the Scene Manager. I want to have my character continually walking in the sidewalk area, so what I'm going to do here is scale up my floor prop to cover most of that sidewalk area. After that, it's as simple as repositioning the character on top of the floor prop and picking it from the Control Settings section as our reference prop. The other settings here are going to remain the same as we had with the Auto On Path mode in order to have our character continually moving within the particular range. The character will start mingling around randomly according to the parameter settings we specified earlier. Naturally, you can do the same for multiple characters on the same floor area as well. Okay, next up is Follow Object mode. We can control multiple characters simultaneously with Player Control mode. However, if we want to randomize the characters with different timing and offsets, we can use this mode to achieve that. I'll demonstrate first with two characters and deactivate the others. If I select my female character, I can switch her over to follow object mode and then select the lead male character as the target. Because the male character is set to player control, I can use the S and D keys to move him down, and you'll see the female character will follow. If you find that your character is following too closely, you can adjust the offset values of horizontal, position, and time. You can see when we adjust these values slightly that it will have an effect on how closely the characters follow one another, as well as time delays. I can repeat the same process with the other characters, making sure that I randomize the aforementioned values to make the movement seem more random and less uniform. Okay, the last mode to look at in this video is macro replay mode, which allows us to arrange our macro recording data for replay. It ensures seamless motion matching, even when you're using different motions. Once you enable macro replay mode on your character, you'll see a playlist appear in the control settings section where you can collect macro data for use. Before I do that though, I need to complete some recordings which will be placed in the macro data tab, so I'll enter into player control mode and do that. I'm going to create three different recordings. What's important to do here is hold the W hotkey before pressing start. I'll walk the character forward first, and it's also important to not release the W key until after you press stop. This will enable seamless motion matching when using macro replay mode. The next step is to use the transform gizmo to move the character to the approximate position that your previous recording ended at. After that, I'll repeat the process, again making sure to hold W before starting and not releasing it until after the recording has stopped. Again, I'll move the character to the approximate position and rotation value at the end of the second recording, and then do a third take. After that, I'm going to take my character back to the very beginning point once again, and switch the character to macro data mode. However, if I try to add a recording, there will be no data found at first. That's because I need to save each of my recordings in the macro data tab, so I'll go ahead and do that by hitting the save icon beside each. Once that's done, I can return to the character settings tab and add them all to my macro list. You can change the order of your recordings by using the up and down icons, but we'll keep them in order since we want to connect them in the same order as we recorded. You can also choose to randomize or repeat them, which aren't really relevant in this case. Once we have everything organized, we can hit start again, and the motions in the macro list will all play in order, which will create a combination of seamless motions recorded all together in the macro data list again. That's about it for this tutorial, guys. Hopefully you learned a bit about how the different motion director modes provide a ton of speed and flexibility when creating motions for your scene characters. Be sure to check out our other videos on the various other new tools with iClone 8, and I'll see you in the next one.